So you learn it first in the key from the record, and then go to different keys.
Then of course, I've been playing so long now, I know the general keys of all these
really?
Tunes. Yeah, I mean, somebody calls a standard tune, and I know it's an E flat or A flat or whatever it is.
Okay.
But if it's a tune I don't know, I'll check it out.
Okay. Now, is this the same approach when you teach as well?
My teaching has changed over the last few years. I'm not as structured as I used to be with the students because every student is different. So I have to give them a lot of leeway and let them sort of imply to me what they need. Because if I tell them, well, you got to do this, you got to do that, they get bored real fast.
Oh, more academic, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I try to.
But they need that. They need that, right?
Well, if they're disciplined and really want to learn, they'll do exactly what I say.
Right.
But if they're hemming and hawing, I mean, there's a lot of students like that these days.
That's a shame.
More than ever before. I don't know why.
Yeah. Okay, let's go to a couple songs, and then we'll come back.
Thanks, Jack.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Phenomenal. Just, you guys are phenomenal. Now, the guitar you're playing is made by who?
Rick McCurdy. He's in New York City downtown. Okay. And it was something we worked on together, and it's a gem.
Okay.
I love it.
Yeah, you're a real credit to him, I have to say. You've had other major companies, I think Yamaha,
yeah.
Ibanez, you've endorsed.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Now you're giving yourself to a local builders,
yeah,
so to speak.
Yeah, I believe in that. He's a small business, we're a small business.
That's wonderful.
Look out for each other.
You're phenomenal. And Jack, you also play, I've seen you with a classical guitar and Just Jazz Guitar Magazine.
Yeah, that's the DiCarlo.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. So you play bossa novas.